Good afternoon, YouTube. Good evening, YouTube. Good evening, Facebook. Good evening, Twitter. Good evening, Instagram. Good evening, all the social platforms that are out there. This is Adrian coming at you live from the Carolinas. So we're going to jump right into it. I just want to thank you guys for picking up my videos on YouTube. So I'm going to ask you guys to subscribe, comment, share. Do all the things that you need to do. So again, anytime I go through some stuff that I feel is going to bring value, I'm going to share it with you guys. So if you think the stuff that I'm bringing you does not bring value, then, you know, by all means, do what you need to do. But if it brings about change in my life, I know some people out there that are trying to get it together as I am. So I'm going to share the value, man. I'm going to share the value. So what we're going to talk about tonight is a book that I'm reading called The Four Agreements. Okay? And it was recommended to me by a young man, 25 years my junior. So it just goes to show that you need to be humble when we are dealing with learning and everything. So I was humbled enough to be able to accept that you have something that you can teach me. And so he said, listen, Adrian, I need you to read this book. So I said, okay, no problem. And it's on Amazon, $5.99, very cheap. It's called The Four Agreements. So it's a self-esteem book. It is a personal freedom book. So as you get older, this is where we want to be. We want to have some type of freedom. We want to have some self-esteem, which is, you know, we want to feel good about ourselves. Excuse me. So this book does those things for you. So I'm going to go over briefly the first chapter of the first agreement. So there's four agreements. So you have be impeccable with your word. Do not take anything personal. Stop making assumptions and do your best. All right. So tonight we're going to tackle be impeccable with your word. Okay. So the first agreement is the most important one and also the most difficult one to honor. So being impeccable with your word is serious because you have to be very aware, very cognizant of the words that we choose to use. So this chapter meant so much to me that there are certain people on Facebook that I am now going to, I won't say delete, but I don't want to see their stories. And they're not bad people. These are not bad people, but they have bad energy that I don't need. I don't need to hear about such and such and such and such. I don't need to hear about such and such and such and such. I don't need to hear about gossip because this is not being impeccable with your word. So your word is the power that you have to create your own world. It is a gift that comes from God. I'm not here to preach, okay? So I'm just, you know, giving you excerpts and the gist of how serious what we're talking about here, the impeccability of your word. So the Gospel of John in the Bible, speaking of the creation of the universe, says in the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word is God. So through the word, we express our creative power. It is through the word that you manifest everything. Regardless of what language you speak, your intent manifests through the word. The word is so powerful that one word can change the life or destroy the lives of millions of peoples. So let's take, for example, a term that was very derogatory towards us. So they used to call us niggers. So even to this day, that word is explosive. So this word still bubbles up inside of some of us that are older and have experienced some of these things to understand the negativity of this word. So this is how powerful words are. You understand what I'm saying? We can take Hitler for another example. He used words to start a world war between two different sets of people, to have this person not like that person because of who they are. And he did it through words. So now we see how powerful words are. So now let's look at the word impeccability and what the word means. Impeccability means without sin. A sin is anything that you do which goes against yourself. All right, I'm going to say this again. Okay? Impeccability means without sin. A sin is anything that you do which goes against yourself. I told you this is about also self-esteem. It's about freeing yourself and building your self-esteem. Everything you feel or believe or say that goes against yourself is a sin. All right, keep it as simple as that. You go against yourself when you judge or you blame yourself for anything. When you are impeccable with your word, you take responsibility for your actions, but you do not judge or blame yourself. Being impeccable with your word is the correct use of your energy. All right? It means to use your energy in the direction of truth, love, and for yourself. If you make an agreement with yourself to be impeccable with your word, just that intention that you will deal in truth and love for yourself, the truth will manifest through you and clean out all the emotional poison that exists within you. Okay? Understand this, right? The power of the word is completely misused in this world. We use the word to curse, to blame, to find guilt, to destroy. Of course, we also use it in the right way, but not too often. Mostly, we use the word to spread our personal poison, to express anger, jealousy, hate, envy, rage. So understand that the word is pure magic. The most powerful gift we have as humans is that we can speak. There are no other beings on this earth that we know about in this dimension that have the ability to speak and use verbiage to communicate with each other. All right? The most powerful gift we have as humans, and we use it against ourselves. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? This is the most powerful gift that we have, and we use it against ourselves. So understanding that we'll use black magic and we'll use white magic. So anger, jealousy, envy, hate, black magic. Love, truth, all the good things for you, white magic. Okay? So gossip is black magic. All right? Gossip is pure poison. Okay? So what we would like to do, or what you can do, what you should do, what you might want to do, is separate yourself from, and listen, I'm in the boat with you, so don't believe that I'm sitting here telling you stuff that I'm holier than thou and so on and so forth. No, this is the step. This is the process to freeing yourself, and I'm in the process of freeing myself. So there are people and things that I need to separate myself from. You understand what I'm saying? So the old saying that misery loves company. Understand that the word is so powerful that it can change your life. Okay? So, excuse me. Understand the first agreement is to be impeccable with your word. You begin to see all the things that can happen in your life. Changes first come in the way you deal with yourself. Love yourself first. And later on, you will see the way that you deal with other people, especially those that you love the most. Impeccability of your word will also give you immunity from anyone putting a negative spell on you. So if you have somebody that is trying to curse you or say bad things about you or call you fat or call you stupid, and this is another reason why the impeccability of your word is so important. So we'll take your children, for instance. You can't call your children stupid. You understand what I'm saying? Because they might buy into that agreement and it can change their life. You can't tell your child that they're fat or they're stupid or that they can't sing or they're not good at sports. You can't say those things to your kids because you are putting them in an agreement that they might buy into and it can ruin their lives. All because of a word. So this is the power that we have with words. So everybody you speak to, it's about love. It's about kindness. It's about being impeccable with your word. Okay, so we're not trying to gossip. We're not trying to be jealous. We're not trying to have envy. We're not trying to have hate, because misery loves company. So we need to separate ourselves from those company. So as I was saying, and I'm almost done, impeccability of the word will give you immunity. It will give you immunity from anyone putting a negative spell on you. You will only receive a negative spell if your mind is fertile ground for that idea. So if you've trained yourself that any sin which is against me, I don't buy into that. So whatever you're trying to put on me, and you want to talk about me, you want to curse me, you want to hate me, there's no fertile ground for that idea to grow. You can measure the impeccability of your word by your level of self-love. This is why I said that this also goes into self-esteem. How much you love yourself, all right? How impeccable are you with your word? You feel good, you feel happy, and you're at peace. Impeccability of the word can lead to personal freedom, to huge success and abundance. It can take away all the negative spells that have been cast upon you by other people. If you understand that you are to understand that without sin, impeccability of your word is without sin, that anything you do which is against yourself, anything you do which is against yourself, you have to stop doing it. All right? Don't judge or blame yourself. Take responsibility for your actions, but don't judge or blame yourself. Don't speak bad to your kids. Don't tell them that they're no good. Don't tell them that they're stupid. Don't tell them all the things that they don't need to hear. All right? So again, the first agreement, be impeccable with your word. Okay? The first agreement is the most important and the most difficult one to honor. So with that being said, my name is Adrian. Go get the book if you want to read more about it. The impeccability of your word. Personal freedom, self-esteem, loving how to, learning how to treat others will bring about massive changes in your life. You will no longer be a subject to gossip and all these dastardly things and talking about people and jealous and envy, and that's hell on earth. We're trying to come out of that. This is Adrian. I'm on YouTube. You guys subscribe to my channel. It's been a pleasure. I'm back. All right, holler at your boy. All right.